gather in our hearts, Lord, and bring peace through our words. Bring peace through our listening. Bring peace through our actions. Bring peace through our silence. Gather in our hearts, O Lord, and bring peace through our lives. Greetings and welcome to 2021 Annual Ecumenical World Day of Prayer, sponsored by Claflin University. Our purpose today is twofold. It's a time to raise funds for UNCF, the United Negro College Fund. And secondly, it's a time to invite the extended community of Claflin to listen as we hear pastors, religious leaders, and soul-stirring music that will cause us to humble ourselves under the mighty hand of God. Mass killings, unpredictable violence, economic uncertainty, racial intolerance, gender intolerance, wars that devastate whole countries, political strife within our own nation, natural disasters, hurricanes and earthquakes, leaving many homeless and hungry, and a pandemic that brings illness and seemingly untimely deaths. Then our colleges, whose budget often falls short due to the lack of increased benevolence. Throughout our efforts today, I invite you to focus both on God's faithfulness and His power to give us peace.
Welcome to Claflin University's virtual Ecumenical Day of Prayer. This event brings together Christians from different denominations in the spirit of working together to develop closer relationships among the local and regional churches. This is very important event also serves as a fundraiser to support UNCF scholarships and deserving Claflin University scholars. The financial gift you make today will help us reach our goal of $15,000. You will also help UNCF fulfill its mission of providing scholarships that enable students at HBCUs to continue their pursuit of a college degree. A college degree will indeed elevate and transform their lives. Thank you for supporting Claflin University and the UNCF, and please enjoy today's program. I am certain you will be inspired by the uplifting music, words of prayer to our Almighty Creator, and prayers of healing, strength, and wisdom from today's guest ministers. Have a blessed day.
Today's scripture is being taken place from Ecclesiastes 3, verse 1, concluding at verse 8. For everything there is a season, and a time for every matter under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up what is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to throw away stones and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to seek and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to throw away, a time to tear and a time to sow, a time to keep silence and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time for war and a time for peace.
As a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. Let us pause for a moment as we remember the COVID-19 victims. Take time to be holy. Speak often with the Lord. Abide in him always and feed on his word. Make friends of God's children. Help those who are weak, forgetting in nothing his blessing to seek. Take time to be holy. Speak often with the Lord. Eternal God, our Heavenly Father, we give you thanks as we gather today to celebrate the member institutions of higher learning of the United Negro College Fund virtually. We give you thanks, O Lord, for this prayer breakfast and our sponsoring institution, Claflin University. Dear God, please continue to bless our president, Dr. Dewan J. Womack, and his family, Mrs. Lakeisha Womack, and their daughter, little Miss Morgan Womack, the faculty and staff, the leal and loyal sons and daughters of Claflin, the alumni, the young and gifted students of Claflin University, and the Orangeburg community. We also pray, O Lord, for the governmental leaders of this nation and the nations of the world. We pray for spiritual and physical healing of our sons and daughters. Please improve race relations at home and abroad. In your holy and righteous name we pray. May we all say, Amen.
Prayer for UNCF students by the Reverend Stanley Rivers, Williams Chapel AME Church. Following will be a selection by Janae Brown, accompanied by P.S. Oaks.
Let us pray as we lift up the Lord on behalf of our UNCF students and our schools. Let us pray. Most gracious Heavenly Father, we come on this day with thanksgiving in our hearts, and we come with praises on our lips. We come as children, some of us bad, before good parents. We come just to say, first of all, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for the many blessings that you have restored upon us. We thank you, Lord, for life. We thank you for health. We thank you, Lord, for a reasonable portion of strength. We thank you, Lord, for this institution that we call Claflin University. We thank you, Lord, for its students, its staff. We thank you, Lord, for all the many blessings. We thank you, Lord, for allowing us to see another ecumenical day of prayer. For you said in your word, if my people who are called by my name shall just humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and forgive their sins, and I will heal their land. Lord, we thank you for the power of prayer. Lord, I thank you for UNCF, for a mind is truly a terrible thing to waste. We come praying now for our UNCF students as they matriculate through their studies. Shield and protect them, Lord, from all hurt, harm, and danger. Pour into them wisdom and knowledge and understanding. We ask your blessings upon them, Lord, in a mighty way, that they can be a blessing to others who will be traveling down that same road. Bless them, Lord, in the hills. Bless them in the fields. Bless them everywhere. Bless everything that they touch. Not only them, Lord, but we are praying for our students. Lord, we pray your blessings upon them everywhere. Bless all of our students this school year. Bless our elementary schools. Bless our high school. Bless our colleges. As we ask for your blessings upon them, we ask your blessings upon the teachers and upon the administrators who will have the unprecedented task of God, giving guidance and direction in these unprecedented times. Lord, you said that you will never leave them nor forsake them. Be with them, Lord. God, direct their path, shield and protect them. And Lord, we ask your health upon them. Lord, we thank you on today. We thank you, Lord, for this day of prayer, because you said in your word, when two or three are touching and agreeing, you said, there I am in the midst. You said, anything we ask, it shall be given unto us. Lord, we are asking your blessings upon our UNCF students and all of our students and our teachers and our administrators in our schools. We praise you on today. We glorify you on today. We magnify your name on today. As we pray, we count it done in the matchless name of Jesus. Amen.
Now let us listen, a prayer for government by the Reverend Vivian Lingard. Friendship United Methodist Church and St. Luke United Methodist Church. Following a selection by Janae Brown, accompanied by Piers Oaks.
Gracious God, in the matchless name of Jesus Christ, we enter your gates with thanksgiving and your courts with praise. We acknowledge the finished work of your Son at the cross as we lift up our hearts and lift up holy hands unto you. Oh God, we present ourselves as a living and holy, a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable in your sight. We put our hope and trust in you and you alone. You are the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last, the author and the finisher of our faith. We look to you in these perilous times, Father, in these times of uncertainty. We ask that you forgive us of any misrepresentation of who you are and who you have made us to be. We ask that you forgive the sins of our forefathers and foremothers. Oh God, as we stand in the gap for America today and ask that you forgive America for its sins. Lord, and we ask that you heal our land as we turn from our wicked and perverse ways. We beseech you, oh Father, to not just heal the land, but heal the hearts and the minds of the people for righteousness' sake. We cast our cares upon you, and we know beyond a shadow of a doubt that just as a king's heart is in your hand and you turn it whichever way you desire, so are the hearts of America's leaders. From the White House to Congress, oh God, you are there. From the legislative body to the judicial representatives, God, you are there. From the formation of our governmental system to its position of the least, you are there. Father, for you are omnipresent and omnipotent. You are everywhere, at the same time with all power in your hands. You can do anything but fail. God, we are here today to set our petition at your feet, that you would speak abundantly into the hearts of this nation's leader and the people that dwell therein. Speak to their hearts as only you can. Speak to our leaders in such a way that they will be compelled to speak what you have imparted unto them in secret to get this country back on its track, back on track. Give them the boldness to operate from a level of right standing with you, God. Open their ear gates to hear you. Sanctify their minds and hearts to receive you. Receive you and cast down every hidden agenda so that your will be done. Not by might, not by power, but by your spirit, O God. Move across America, move across this nation as you did when you formed this world out of nothing. Move across this nation as you did when you parted the Red Sea. Move across this nation as you did when you resurrected your Son, Jesus the Christ, and set him at your right hand. Move, oh God, move. We are calling for your miraculous power to hit the earth today. Create miracles upon miracles, peace upon peace today, oh God. Meet the need. Meet the request, Father. We need you like never before. We command an atmospheric shift in this nation, oh God. We set the nation's atmosphere in divine order. We set it in its proper place. Make it conducive to your will. In Jesus' name. And we all will say, amen.
I don't know about tomorrow. I just live from day to day. I don't borrow from his sunshine for a sky's may turn to gray. About my future, for I know what Jesus.
UNCF Appeal, Dr. Marcus Burgess, Interim Vice President for Institutional Advancement here at Claflin University. And a selection would follow by Minister Rosemary S. Griffin and Company.
This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. I am Dr. Marcus H. Burgess, a member of the class of 1996, and I am proud to serve as the Interim Vice President for Institutional Advancement here at Claflin University. Today, this UNCF Ecumenical Day of Prayer wishes to not only bring communities of faith together, but to raise necessary funds for deserving students here at Claflin University. We have assembled religious leaders from our community to share prayers and praises. We have also gathered here to share the message that a mind is a terrible thing to waste, but a wonderful thing to invest in. You can make your gift right now in several different ways. You can go to our website at alumni.claflin.edu/UNCFPrayer, or you can use the platform Givelify, which many of you know at your churches, which is shown on the screen. Or you can text to give. Please text CUGiving at 844-596-3403. Or you can call 803-535-5357, and one of our advancement personnel can help you. We thank you for your continued support of Claflin University, its faculty, its staff, and more importantly, its students. Always remember that a mind is a terrible thing to waste, but a wonderful thing to invest in.
My name is Reverend Cindy Muncy, and I serve St. Andrew's United Methodist Church in Orangeburg, South Carolina. But I don't serve alone. Methodists know ourselves to be connected, to share the same spiritual DNA of Christ's blood. I serve alongside clergy of all denominations and no denomination. I also serve alongside laity. All of us, different races, genders, experiences, and perspectives. But one of the many causes that unites all of us is racism. When people say that God is colorblind, it isn't true. God created color and pronounced it good. And God is in the process of redeeming color, working all things together for our good, for the good of all, for goodness to be experienced and shared by all. The United Methodist Church has this to say as a response to racism from their 2016 Book of Discipline. The United Methodist Church proclaims the value of each person as a unique child of God and commits itself to the healing and wholeness of all persons. The United Methodist Church recognizes that the sin of racism has been destructive to its unity throughout its history. Racism continues to cause painful division and marginalization. The United Methodist Church shall confront and seek to eliminate racism, whether in organizations or in individuals, in every facet of its life and society at large. The United Methodist Church shall work collaboratively with others to address concerns that threaten the cause of racial justice at all times and in all places. This is our understanding and hope in response to racism. But nothing is transformed apart from the work of the Holy Spirit. So I invite you now to pray with me as I share a prayer written from St. Luke United Methodist and adapted for today's service. Let us pray. Almighty God and Father of us all, God of peace and justice, our hearts are hurting. We struggle to find the right words to pray, as there is so much pain. We are reminded that Jesus used a whip to turn the tables over in the temple, and at the same time taught his disciples to be peacemakers. When they came to arrest him in the garden, he told his disciple to put away the sword. We pray that the violence we see would be replaced by real solutions, changes in both hearts and actions. We pray that somehow we would recognize and change any systems that mistreat people, that treat people differently, intentionally or unintentionally, simply because of the color of their skin. God, because we seek to live and love like Jesus, we thank you for law enforcement officers who serve and protect us. Grant them wisdom and discernment to make the difficult decisions they must make each day. Most of all, God, show each one of us what we can do so that justice rolls down like water and righteousness like an ever-flowing stream. In the name of Jesus, the Christ, the Prince of Peace, we pray for love's sake. Amen.
Prayer for health. The Reverend Adonikin Hudson, Stepping Stone Outreach Ministry.
My name is Adonikim Hudson, and I have the honor and privilege to serve the Stepping Stone Holiness Church out of Timminsville, South Carolina, as the executive pastor under Bishop Hudson, as well so as the Stepping Stone Orangeburg Outreach Campus here in Orangeburg, South Carolina, as the general overseer. There have been over 875,000 cases of COVID, 12,702 deaths in the state of South Carolina. There have been over 44 million coronavirus cases in America, over 722,000 deaths. But what statistics don't tell us is that there have been over 34 million recoveries. This morning, I want to pray a simple prayer of healing for our nation, healing for our state, healing for our county. So if you would join me in a word of prayer. Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we come to you now, most humbly and gracious as we know how. Father, we thank you for this moment of prayer. We thank you for this moment to be able to grace your throne this way to communicate to you. And Father, we ask you now, first, before we ask you of anything, we must thank you for all things. Thank you for life. Thank you for health. Thank you for strength. Thank you for this gathering. Thank you for those that are viewing live, Father. We appreciate you. We honor you. Thank you for the breath that we're breathing. Thank you, God, for just the opportunity by which we're able to do this. And Father, I ask you this morning, you said in your word, if my people, which are called by my name, will humble themselves and pray, seek my face, turn from their wicked ways, then shall you hear from heaven and heal the land. Father, we come this morning obeying your word. We come, God, seeking your face, praying to you this morning, God, that you would heal our land. Heal our land, God, of this wicked coronavirus. Heal our land, God, of diabetes, of cancer, and all of manner of terminal diseases. Heal our land, God. We need you. Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus, you said in your word, oh God, that by your stripes that we were healed. So we claim healing tonight, this morning. We claim health, God, for those that are listening. Father, you said in your word, beloved, you wish above all things that we may prosper and be in good health. You said in your word, God, that the prayer of faith shall save the sick and the Lord shall raise him up. And if he have committed sins, they shall be forgiven them. You said in your word, heal me, O Lord, and I shall be healed. Save me, and I shall be saved, for thou art my praise. You said in your word, behold, I will bring it health and cure, and I will cure them and reveal unto them the abundance of peace and truth. And so, Father, we pray your word to you, and we ask you now, O God, to send the spirit of healing across the airways, across, God, this world. As we stand here, we pray for healing for all of those who may be on their hospital beds, God, that are sick and that are dying, God, of COVID. We pray now that you would heal their bodies from the crown of their heads to the sole of their feet. We know you're able. You have all powers in your hand, and we thank you for it now. We praise you for healing now. It is in the immaculate, most immeasurable, precious name of Jesus we do pray. Amen.
a message from UNCF, Mrs. Rosalyn McGinnis, UNCF Area Development Director.
Thank you, Dr. Warmack, board members, and the Claflin family for inviting me to once again be a part of the annual UNCF Ecumenical Day of Prayer. It is my honor and privilege to bring greetings on behalf of UNCF's CEO, Dr. Michael Lomax, and our UNCF family. During the past 18 months, we have completely changed how we do business, socialize, and engage with each other. And unfortunately, many of us, myself included, have had to deal with storms that forever changed our lives. However, in the midst of our respective storms, we have remained steadfast and faithful because we know storms don't last always, and after the storm, there is peace on the other side, a peace that comes from knowing God is watching over us, hears our prayers, and creates miracles. So this morning, I am especially grateful to be a part of hearing and receiving the many prayers of protection, covering, and thanksgiving that these extraordinary prayer warriors are providing for our Claflin family and our amazing students. I believe that by trusting in God and knowing prayer absolutely changes things, the storms we experience make us much more resilient, stronger, and better prepare us to address the obstacles that life will inevitably bring. The storms also remind us that we need each other. We cannot do it alone. UNCF and Claflin University help our students to weather their storms. UNCF is on the front lines helping students to ensure that they have access to a high-quality education and creating better futures. We do this by ensuring our students have the financial resources they need, our schools have the resources they need to educate, empower, and equip our students and this nation with exceptional graduates who are ready to enter the workforce. We also do this by advocating for social justice and equity for our schools and students. And UNCF does this by recognizing and remembering that a mind is a terrible thing to waste, but a wonderful thing to invest in. So, my challenge to all of you viewing our program this morning is to make a gift, a contribution, an investment in making a difference in the lives of the students Claflin and UNCF serves. Your donation may be the one that helps a young person to overcome a storm that they are facing. Thank you, and may God bless each and every one of you.
In closing, our benediction by Reverend Shirley Gordon, Orangeburg Wesley Foundation.
I pray that you have enjoyed yourself this blessed morning. I am the Reverend Shirley Peterson Gordon, and I am the director of the Wesley Foundation, a United Methodist campus ministry, which supports Claflin University and South Carolina State University. Today, I will offer prayer for our churches and our community and give the benediction. So let us pray. Most merciful Father, as we conclude this morning's United Negro College Fund Ecumenical Day of Prayer, we thank you for being with us and for all those who have participated in this event. Send your heavenly blessings upon your people and the Church Universal, that all its members may dwell together in unity and in love. I pray that you give your church the strength, the power, and the courage to be your hands and your feet to all people in our communities wherever we serve. Keep far from us all self-will and discord. Spirit of promise and spirit of unity, we thank you that you are also the spirit of renewal and transformation. Empower our faith communities with righteousness and enable us to faithfully serve your mission of making disciples of Jesus Christ for the transformation of the world. And now, let us go forth into the world in peace and dedicate ourselves to the service of the Lord. as we hold fast to that which is good, rendering no person evil for evil, strengthening the fainting heart, supporting the weak, helping the needy and the afflicted, and honoring all people. Let us love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. So may the Lord bless and keep us, and make his face to shine upon us and be gracious unto us. May the Lord lift his countenance upon us and give us peace this day, now, and forevermore. And let the people of God say amen, amen, and amen.